Welcome to the video. You know my style is just to wing it, to do it now. Don't delay, and all my videos are just spontaneous. I don't have a script or anything. So why should this one be any different? We're going to take a look back, a retrospective on all the videos that have been posted here on Christ Clarity. 252 videos so far. 133 hours, which is about 24 hour days worth of videos about Christ Clarity Reassurance. The big boost is now. It's coming up, resonating with reassurance, acceptance of reality as it is, stepping out of time into eternity. Over 60,000 views. Thank you all very much. This is the old familiar website that I have been slaving away at for quite some time now, putting up 133 hours of videos, and doing this, of course, so that we are prepared for what I call the big boost. So we started out a long time ago. I don't know what the date was. It's not really important. With this one, Christ Clarity one. Those are my three spiritual mentors. Resonators of reassurance, Jesus, and onto my mom, Ramana Maharshi. Those are the ones who have helped me the most, for sure. Then we got into Christ Clarity 2, and I started using Creative Commons pictures as a background. And in the beginning, I had a lot of creativity to the videos using pictures, using Windows Photo Story 3 is how I did that. Impossible to default on here. Not all the titles fit on here for some reason. That's typical of YouTube. You're not exactly sure what you're going to get. There you go. Just put on a pair of shoes, actually. That's Ramana Maharshi's famous aphorism of don't ask the guru to remove all the thorns from the world. Just the guru is going to tell you, just put on a pair of shoes. Very true. And this was The Great Divide, which I know was set to a song. There's a beautiful panoramic picture of the Himalayan mountains. And no need to quote scriptures. And look at the third bird there, the one on the right. I like that. So a lot of these videos have this very nice aesthetic backgrounds to them. No PhD, no problem. Don't try to fix anything. That is true. Don't try to fix the problems of the world. Just put on a pair of shoes. And this is a picture, Simple Facts or Effective Facts, beautiful place. That's actually Silver Rock Golf Course in Indian Wells, California. Truth is very simple. Yes, that is what we have been trying to convey here, that truth is very simple. This hypothetical scenario we call existence is completely unnecessary. Sheer simplicity of it. So getting older equals opportunity. That is true. Just because we're getting older doesn't mean we can't give it all we got. God versus God. Yeah. Meaning the true prime creator versus the God of belief. Belief thinks that it is God. It is our God and tries to insist we follow its guidance. Assimilate wisdom now before it's too late. Amen to that. And we're coming up to a time now where it's going to be, we need to have assimilated a lot of wisdom. So I packed all these videos in fast to give everyone an opportunity to assimilate the big picture clarification in time, so that when the crises really hit hard, we will say, you know what, we're familiar with the big picture clarity. Everyone will be saved eventually, yes, but we don't want to go into another cycle, that is for sure. Easy inspiration, casual salvation, right? We can do it. We're doing it right here, right as we go along, by the seat of our pants. A new look at celebrity, being or becoming. Only one is true. That is so true. Only one is true, not both. Becoming is the hypothetical, and being is reality. And this very interesting one, which didn't get a lot of views, showed Anandamayi Ma, and on the right had all these day-by-day front-page news articles, and they're flashing by really fast, and then you get a contrast of someone who's not the slightest bit interested in the news at all, just radiating reassurance compared to paying attention to news articles. That was one of my more creative pieces. I never knew what people would watch, really. I still don't. Relaxed awareness, It's hit and miss. Christ's technology and salvation, it's really hit and miss. I have no idea. My favorites, often my favorites, I feel really good, they get the fewest views. And the ones that I don't think are so interesting get the most. It's okay to be free. Yeah, and we really deserve to be free, that is for sure. Authorship of the universe, the pointing out what really is the author of existence. A very important issue that we've been clarifying. Mind is not the problem. That is true. Mind is the servant. The problem is the idea that spirit shows, wanting to be prime creator. That is the problem. And mind then presents this hypothetical scenario. Spirit remembering spirit. There's a beautiful background there of pictures of the earth at night. Some very beautiful videos that I really enjoyed putting together. Long talk. That's when the talk started getting long. Okay, before that, they weren't so long. Now, they an hour. There's another one. Long talk 3. I don't know what happened to long talk 2. Really don't. The greatest adventure. Yeah, we're on it right now. That is for sure. Don't be a hero, right? Don't be a hero. Don't try to fix the problems of existence. Don't try to be a hero in that way. Don't try to figure out how to survive annihilation, because we will never face annihilation in reality. The totality of truth. That's a beautiful Lotus video using the background there in 3 minutes. That's the shortest one probably ever. I can find my way home, right? We certainly can. The spiritual child speaks. It was rotoscoping. I really enjoyed doing these. It was very, very beautiful. Know who you are, the spirit. Another, also using the rotoscoping. Spiritual discipline, destiny. This had some really, I started to get into some interesting special effects as background material. But what I found out was the best news, there's another special effect, that people really are more interested in the message than any of the video, actually. And interestingly, when I put up videos with just like one picture, just static, one static picture, people seem to like that just as much as all these very time-consuming, like this one. What are we waiting for? I put tremendous effort into the backgrounds of this video. Just really slaved. It was very, very amazing special effects. But people want to hear the message more than the video. Just say no. Again, a lot of effort in that one. Where did existence come from? Again, talking about what's really going on, and that this is a really actually a hypothetical scenario. Being imagined, blind faith. Well, this is a time lapse here, I believe. It's so simple, but we must get used to it. Absolutely. We must get familiar with it, and hopefully some of us have. I know I have in making these videos. Choosing peace is simply difficult. Yeah, it's very simple, but difficult, because we're belief tricks us. Easy honesty, right? And in fact, honesty is the easiest way. Try to be honest with yourself. Trust in truth. Exactly. Truth will get you there. An important chat about truth, and we're continuing on here. Now, I'm not showing up. I wasn't interested. I did a channel once where I had God is not angry. Very important. That is very true. Did a channel once where it was just my head giving talks. A lot of videos, and there were no views at all. No one looked at them. Sales resistance to the extraterrestrials. Well, we know how important that is now, don't we? Because the full Monty, the full press, court press is being applied to us right now. Marketing an agenda in another cycle of existence, fourth dimensional, 4D. Lotus Superman. I really enjoyed doing this one, but it didn't really get much response. Very, very interesting and creative works. But set your universe free. Now, here's one that I really love. What about love? What about love? Well, I love this one, but it didn't get many views and didn't really ring a bell. This is Iguazu Falls, the effect, the slow-mo effect, and the coloration I did. It's just like, wow. But again, people are interested in the message, and so I got that message. They're interested in the message. There is no co-redeemer. There's only one plan of salvation. There's not some co-redeemer that has another plan. Very important to know. I'm that guy your mother warned you about, right? I say, don't listen to that guy. Play it safe. Play it safe. Don't listen to that guy. Just go along with the norm. Go along with the flow, the current, and don't listen to that guy. But actually, you should listen. leave the Eagle Satsang of Death. Absolutely. Again, another very arty type of video with that I slaved over. But and here we go. I make a cameo, my first cameo. Love it the way that it is. And I said, I don't want to appear on these videos. Well, why should I appear on these videos? Let me put these really neat backgrounds. This was actually an aquarium. Resist Not Evil Part 1. I was waiting in a doctor's office, and I just took the video of this aquarium while I was waiting. And here we have one of my spiritual mentors, Sri Anandamayi Ma. And again, just completely blissed out at all times, no matter what was happening in the world. Very great example. And here we also have a video which has gotten tremendous number of views. I think about 13,000 views or so. And people really like it. And another one that people have really, really taken to. This has over 16,000 views. So Hermana's a little bit ahead. And I just was amazed that these videos have so many views. But you know, these were two great resonators of reassurance, and people know about them. Advice from A Course in Miracles. Very few views. Shocking to me. Shocking, really. This was artwork by Nicholas Rorick, and just for me, it's the greatest artwork ever done in the world. And I thought that this was really superb, and no interest in it. Very, very interesting. Doing all of this work, you come across very interesting anomalies. Back and away from the bonfire, indeed. Again, I threw some very nice backgrounds on there, but and the ego at its root is gibberish. That is so true. And here we have, why wait to be free of suffering? Okay, why wait? Why wait? Indeed, why wait? We got to stop waiting. That is for sure. Here I get into using a beautiful background on the North Shore of Hawaii. Going at full blast, the overlay North Shore Satsang. And I have a number of these North Shore Satsangs using the same background. I found it be very soothing and very beautiful. And eventually, I tried something else, as I am wont to do. And here's one that absolutely flopped, but for me, it is my favorite video of all of them. It is just unbelievably powerful for me, and yet there was no interest in this one. So I said, okay, you know, move on. Come on, keep moving. Focus on the absolute. Here's another North Shore Satsang. It's all the same to me. If something works, it works. If not, move on to something else. Stay with it. Okay, very true. That's exactly what we have to do. Using absolutes to find freedom. This was done on a golf course. The background was the golf course. I tried that. Don't wait. These are all the ocean currents. Incredible, incredible depiction of ocean currents, which I found to be interesting. But again, maybe it distracts from the message. This was someplace in background of Kauai, I believe. I got these off the off YouTube Creative Commons. Thank you to all the people who put their videos in Creative Commons. That is supremely helpful and very aware. Very aware. This was another golf course one, which was quite interesting for me to do it. One step away. Oh, I had a lot of trouble on this video, believe me. Holy cow. This kind of began to spell the end my efforts to do sophisticated videos, because I was using a program that was super buggy, and I would spend all these hours slaving away getting it set up, only to render it overnight, take like 13 hours to render, and it would crash during the night, and I'd get up in the morning, there'd be nothing there, and then I'd try it again, and I would do it again. So I'd waste like 2 or 3 days slaving away at a video and not get anything. And so I just said, holy cow, this isn't working for me. Plus, my eyes were getting severely burned out, weakened, very badly weakened. I have weak eyes, very weak eyes, bad eyesight. And all this staring at the screen, I had to get closer and closer to see what I was doing. And my field, my ability to focus was being severely diminished. When I try to drive, I just say, wow, it's hard to really focus the way I should be focusing. And it got so bad, I said, you know, I really have to find some other way to do these videos, because I cannot be slaving away for 8 hours at a time setting up all these complex videos and then, you know, trying to render them and having them crash and having to do it over again. Oh, no. So I started shifting over to one single background picture and doing it live. Everything just straight live, one background picture. And this was one of those. And here is another one. And that took all the strain off of my eyes. I didn't have to spend any time at all editing on these. These are direct to Ustream and then directly uploaded to YouTube. And that really was a supreme help. And people liked them. They didn't care. They were just a static picture there, which I found to be amazing. And then I started using special effects to kind of spice up the situation. So let me just try something weird, you know, backgrounds that have some special effects on them live as I was recording. What is this? That's a background too, huh? And then this is another special effects. Coming on strong. Coming on strong. I think I used some music for that, which is another thing I found out. People really are not interested in having music on the videos. Most of the early ones, I tried to put some background music on. But again, I found out that just didn't resonate. To descent into ghost dancing. And here's where I start making a cameo, another cameo appearance, not really wanting to do so. But I said, well, let me try it. Memorial Day Satsangathon. I remember that going in very strong into summertime, where I just spent all day going for recording these videos, three videos, like, what was it, about 7 hours of recording, trying to set the tone for the summer. And then another use of effects while recording. My camcorder has a bunch of effects. It's actually a webcam. It has a bunch of effects, and I can use those effects, but it's very buggy that way. Another thing about my camcorder is that it doesn't really record natural video well. Not at all. I have to adjust all the controls, and it's very difficult to try and get looking natural, especially in the situation I'm recording in. This is another special effect. It's go time, which is it's an old time video effect. And now I'm starting to make more appearances with using filters on the webcam. I record outside. Now here is again Nana Mai Ma when she was young. And interesting, people didn't resonate with her either. So I said, well, there's no reason then to keep putting her picture up, really. Okay, I'm using other effect. Now, I record outside, and during the summertime, the sun, it moves through the trees, and the angle, it keeps hitting me in the face. And so I have to keep shifting all the controls while I'm recording. This is a painting that I actually found in a thrift shop. Pretty amazing painting. That's a picture of it. Avoiding the zombie apocalypse, really. And here's a Pleasant Shakov Satsang, a picture. I used some of the pictures that I took on some of the trips. Here's also these pictures that I took on various trips. There was a time when I traveled all over California taking video and pictures. That was like back in 2002, 2003, something like that. I knew I had to do it now or never. ABCs of Moving Beyond. Okay, now I make another cameo, side sort of artistic sort of thing. I was trying to be artistic about it. Pictures I took on a trip, Mojave Desert. We are not lost in time and space. There's another golf course thing. These are pictures I took at the, I think, the U.S. Open at Harding Park during the summertime as a background. I try to mix it up and provide interesting stuff for people. Okay, now we're going to start. I decided, these pictures, they're kind of boring. Someone suggested to me that they have an easier time following what's being said if they can see me speaking. And I thought about that, and I said, maybe there's something to that. If you see someone talking, you're somehow able to better follow what they're saying. And so in heeding that advice, I said, well, let me try talking on camera. And there I go with another just a white line blackout special effect. That's inside, actually. That was inside. Usually I'm outside. Day or night, outside. I prefer that greatly. And I'm moving towards speaking on camera, but still using special effects, trying to make it interesting. This was something artistic I did. Two worlds. Again. And again, this is something the razzle-dazzle with all sorts of moving slideshows, etc., which didn't resonate with anyone. North Shore Satsang with picture-in-picture. Multidimensional. Spiritual rant. Okay, again, I played with the contrast and brightness and gain and color and saturation and all these kinds of things and color to get different looks, which just kind of, for me, it just makes it more interesting for me. It's not as boring. I just don't want to sit there, be a talking head. Let's at least keep something interesting. Now, here's it outside where I'm getting struck by the sun during this video. And I have to keep adjusting the video constantly. But it's fun. It's a lot of fun. Adds a little bit of drama to the situation. And so every video I look different. And again, the sun washing out the background. Freedom of speech, and this one really getting zapped by the sun. So I said, what the heck, let us just come up with some new look, as it were. And again, it's interesting to do this because it's the person is not important, the body is not important. It's good to get used to simply the message. Two options, one choice. That is right. We have to see clearly between the two options. And when we see it clearly, then we can make a meaningful choice. And so here, the sun is going through the leaves and striking in various different places, giving this really interesting effect. And I said, let's just go with it. Why not? Pretty soon, it's going to be winter anyway. And there won't be any sun coming in. So make the most of it. The essential essence of... Okay, these are summer recordings, which was a lot of fun. And I use this program that I'm using, Ustream program, to do this double picture here, which is another look. Again, never had any comments on the video. Really, the substance, the visual substance of the videos, very very rarely any comments at all. So I said, well, okay, let me just keep on going. And this was something that was tried, and that really didn't work at all. Just a cool down video to kind of help give people a sort of a very beautiful way to just stop, calm their thoughts down, and that really didn't take off either. So I continued on here. This is Ramana, silent cool down. Yeah. As I said, why go to all this effort? Let's just keep it simple. So I started to keep it simple, and here's, I think, the first one where I really just kept it very simple. It's a long one, where it's just straight out, flat out, no filters, anything going on, just straight out simple talk. And again, a lot of sunlight on this one. And this one I just reversed the camera to just take a picture of the sun hitting the plants, I believe, and that gave a lot of very colorful background. Drop the path now, right? It's also this single picture, and I started going back more and more now to just basic, flat out, no frills, just talking. And very easy. Okay, that's the easiest way to go about it for me. And this one's desaturated, which I actually like this look a lot, is just take the color out of it. And for me, it's very plain, very simple, and something I like. And then this one, I faded out, tried a faded look here. And then trying to get just a more natural color look, which is not easy with all this severe lighting that was going on. So I said, what the heck, let's just throw up a colored edges type of thing. And then went back to basic stuff. And here I emphasize the reds. So it gives kind of a funny look there, but a different look. It's kind of funny seeing myself look different. I look at, and it's like, huh, wow, very interesting, actually. Kind of an Anglo-Saxon look there with a flaxen hair and stuff. And okay, that's a more somewhat realistic. I don't really look like that. You never look, the way you look on camera is different. Now, I try to really... funny special effect on that one, and I said, enough of that. This was a dark film noir type of look. I said, why not? Let's make it interesting for everyone. I know the curriculum is quite difficult. It's a stretch working out, so sometimes it's good to throw some seasoning into the mix. Again, a washed out, no color to it, very stark and simple. It's super hard to get the same look twice because of the changing lighting conditions. It's amazing. Again, very colorful one using the camera pointed towards the sun. Now I go back to a background that a moving background is actually a video background, but the resolution was too high and it wouldn't play smoothly. I have to have low resolution on the videos here if I use them, so it's kind of jerky, the whole thing, but very beautiful background. But again, a lot of effort, a lot of time spent, and we're running out of time, so we need to really press forward. And I just said, let's just do it. No path, no realization, etc., etc., like that. Abide in unconditional love. Absolutely. I keep trying to present from as many angles as possible. Now, just I decided, let's do something different. I came across these chrome grates, and I said, let's just do something. Let's have some fun. It's hot. It's baking hot summertime. So this is some summer fun. I put that on, and it got all these amazing colors. So at least it kept it interesting for me. Again, I tried, made it like a triangle. I was trying these various things. All consent is false consent, true. No one has lost their magnificence. And so I did a series of these videos with this chrome. There's another one like that. But again, no, didn't resonate with anybody. So I said, okay, let's drop that. Keeping advancing the narrative. So now I said, okay, let's keep advancing the narrative here. And these are just basic, no frills. And then again, I said, let's throw a special effect in just for the heck of it. And that's what I did. Ooh. it just gives me something to focus on and say, okay, let's do this. Let's do this. Okay. Get ready for translation. Absolutely. And sometimes I'd wear a visor if the sun was too strong. Sun was really, really pounding me right in the face. I said, let me wear this visor and put the headphones on in a different way. The two belief systems. So I'm just sitting there very simply on this outdoor two-seat wicker bench with a cushion on it, and just in front of a wall, and just have a couple palm trees on each side, and am just talking to the webcam. That is it. It's outside. And assert your spiritual rights. There you go. So I'm letting my hair grow longer during this time. I don't know why. Just don't want to go get a haircut. Too expensive. The subtle energy in bluffing reality. So these videos, every time, it's not rehearsed. I don't have a topic necessarily. I just sit down and say, you know what? We have to do the very best we can right now, and let us just see what happens if we make a great effort to share as much clarity as possible. And then making that effort, it's this clarity starts to flow. Now a lot of times, it doesn't start flowing right away. It takes a while. I need to warm up to it. And as the video goes on, I get better and better and better and better and better. That's often like musicians are that way. When you start out, you may not feel like you have it, and it takes a while before you really warm up and get going. But maybe after 30 minutes or an hour or so, then you really can catch fire. So I would take these videos deep. There's a three-hour one, my first three-hour one. I found out that's the maximum amount of time I can record here. If you take it really deep, towards the end, suddenly you make breakthroughs, real breakthroughs, which is, I say, people try to listen all the way through if you have the time, because it gets better. It gets better and better and better. The video builds. It's like a symphony. And you can reach points of wow, really wow points in this, lessening your anxiety. Yeah. And we have been doing that. Absolutely. The one that gets helped the most by all these videos is, of course, the one who did all the videos, which is yours truly. When you try to help other people, you help yourself more than anyone, because you have to focus in and try to come up with what is helpful. And when you come up with what is helpful, you realize, oh, this is also helpful for me. That's how it works. I say, oh my gosh, that's really helpful for me. I need to listen to that advice. But I'm really trying to give the advice to others. Follow your compassion 100%. So as I'm working really hard, giving everything I've got to help others, all this clarity comes pouring out from somewhere. I don't know where. I said, where'd that come from? And I say, my gosh, that's extremely good advice. I'm going to follow that advice. So I end up following my own advice in the videos. Now, if you wonder, do I watch the videos? No, I don't. I think I've only watched a couple of them. I don't need to because I experienced them while I was taping them. So I already know, I've already experienced it, you know, very intensely by doing the taping. So for some reason, I'm always on to the next one. I don't go back and watch my own videos. That's pretty funny. Don't become a drone, yeah. And this one, I sort of took a slight detour, and then I said, no, let's get back to business here. The isness that we are, yes. And the videos, for me, they become more and more profound. Although they've always been going in the right direction, they do become more profound. The door is open right now. In fact, later on, we realize that there is no door at all. There's a doorway, but no door there. Feel the attitude of freedom. Yes, indeed. And I do these videos different times. Hey, looks like I'm laying hands on someone there. Be healed. I do them like weekends. I often do them in the morning or midday or in the evening. And on work days, I usually do them in the evening. Or if there's no work early in the morning, I might do one early in the morning if there's no work. But if I get home from work, I will do them after work, either in the afternoon or at nighttime. These days it gets dark so early. Of course, it's nighttime. When I get home, it's already basically dark. Okay. I'm saying, let me try special effect. Some of them were very colorful. Happy October. Okay. So now we're getting into October. Now we're getting into the time where the intensity is starting to ratchet up. And I'm laying down more videos. I tried one that was very dark. It didn't work out very well. That one. But the message is good. Everyone already feels perfect right now, which is true. In reality, we all do feel perfect right now. Turning the tide against the bully of belief. Okay, now we start to introduce the bully of belief. Nothing's really happening here. I just did a video today saying that nothing has ever happened here, which is true. Nothing has ever happened here, which is a very high type of teaching. These videos are trying to give the very highest teaching possible so that we're ready for the big boost. That is the whole purpose of these videos, is to be exposed ahead of time to the highest teachings possible. So when the big boost comes, we'll say, yeah, I can go with that. This is familiar. I feel I can handle this. Gather your attention. Some of the videos, turned out really nice, but it wasn't easy to get the lighting and everything. Wow. Change the background a little bit here just for something different, but then I decided, let's just go back at some point to the wicker. I threw another one in there. That's like Technicolor, this one. Universal spiritual exercise, and that one didn't really fly either. Sometimes I try to give out exercises, but those have not resonated. So I said, well, okay, let's just keep plugging away, do the best we can. The big boost, okay, introducing the big boost, very important. It's what's coming, that's what's on our menu. Really get real video, time to get real. Getting to the end of the path, right? That's what we're trying to do, get to the end of the path, ASAP. Sandy and Satsang, okay, that's when Sandy came in and I said, hey, try the best you can to get through this. Keep focused. I was really exhorting people to stay focused. as best they can. During the crises, that was a crisis. One of the crises that's coming. Many are coming. Watch the video, okay? And then there I put a backwards giant's hat on, which is a different look. A bumpy road ahead, absolutely. Introducing, as always, what I do in the videos is I don't shirk from pointing out that the bumpy road is ahead. So it's not all just talking about accepting reality as it is. That's paramount, but it's by recognizing there's a very bumpy road ahead, we should get really more serious about accepting reality as it is. And so I'm not going to lie and say, oh, the future is great, everything's going to be wonderful, it's just all coming up roses. That's not what I see. Some see it that way, and I don't argue with them. They have their perspective, but I see it's going to be highly problematic, to say the least. Now, we talk about election day, so I sometimes I get topical. If there's some really, really important situation going on, I will address it and then try to turn your attention away from it towards salvation, towards accepting reality as it is. Because these big events tend to be enormous time wasters for us, and they can really set us back severely, and we can't afford to be set back right now. We cannot afford to backslide too much right now. And here I say America commits suicide. In essence, that is how I see it, that a decision was made to go in a certain direction, which is one that is based on belief. It's not the direction of salvation at all. Even though it seems very promising, it won't turn out that way at all. Okay. The big boost is on its way. So now, you know, I say, okay, we've had the crisis. There was a turning point. The election was a big turning point in history, historic turning point. And I say, okay, well, it is what it is, and I knew for sure that it would happen this way ahead of time. I saw it ahead of time, what's going to happen, and so I said, okay, it's happened. And there was a little bit of shock, and I said, okay, let us refocus now. The big boost is on its way. And so right immediately just got into this mode of saying, let's go full blast towards the big boost. The overlay is the answer. Keep expressing the overlay throughout all these videos, using my own terminology. From what I see, that I feel is very apt terminology. Nothing in this world is worth dying for. Again, I put some playlists and some videos together on this theme. It didn't really fly either, but it was very helpful for me, I tell you that. Yes, we can stand up to belief. And outing the Joker in the deck, yeah, which is certainly belief. Trying to keep the videos a little shorter, a little hour or something. How to put off your death, and this is an important one where people are getting a lot of trouble right now. It's been a very bumpy road, especially now, and we need to use our will to say, not now, not now. We're too busy. We've got no time to die right now. No time to die. We have no time. Welcome to the apocalypse, indeed. Apocalypse means the unveiling. So we're there's a theme here of getting, as we get closer to 12/21/12, of being on point, saying, come on, let's really be at our very best right now. No one can learn to love the hypothetical scenario. No one can learn to love time. These times, yet either. We don't need any results in existence. Very true. Opportunity is here now. Yeah. And it really is. Two paths, only one is true. That is right. There's the path of belief, and there's a path of accepting reality as it is. And only one of those paths is leads to truth. That is for sure. Christ Mass Clarity Countdown. I'm starting to count down towards Christmas, day 30, as we are nearing Christmas. I think we have, 6 days now before 12/21/12, and sidestepping the upcoming calling. This is a different type of video, which I used some Creative Commons videos from other people, and it's a very serious one. to try and let us know that the world means business. Okay, what's going on in the world really means business, and we have to mean business. Absolutely. But having done that, I said, let's get back to the basics here. Now, this one was so important to me. I asked, please watch this one all the way, because it just built and built and built and built and built. And I felt that just had this incredible breakthroughs in this video. I felt super important how depression comes about. I saw very clearly what causes depression. And it was just like, oh my gosh. It was a historic video, this one, where I became just acutely aware suddenly of what caused depression. And now I know that great demon that has terrorized my life, depression. I suddenly recognized what causes it, for sure. I knew it. I said, oh my gosh, from now on, I'll always know what causes depression, and I'm going to be truly free of it. That was just enormously important video for me. And it got a lot of watches. People did watch it. Depression is absolutely horrendous. It can be. In my case, it was just, I had the worst. I hit rock bottom, complete rock bottom. Couldn't go any lower. And from that point, there was nowhere to go but up. And depression has been just the bête noire, that which has bedeviled my life. This lifetime was bedeviled by it. And truly a frightening thing. And this one, I start getting very topical about the world and start sort of spilling the beans about the agenda coming up in the world and how it's being hidden. And cutting through the matrix, I continued this theme, where I sort of felt like this is sort of the last chance to do that, because when the big boost comes, we're going to turn the page. So I start again, I go back to, hey, let's get ready for a big celebration, because it's coming up. Making an all-out push now. We realize that 12/21/12 is coming up very soon, and it's a critical date. The world's not going to end, as far as I know. But in a subtle way, it is. Okay, it both is and it isn't. Morning clarity. I tried a shorter video in the morning. I tried to get going on that, but it's been hard to stick with that. Getting ready for the ETs to come out. In other words, disclosure. Talking about what is going to happen when disclosure happens. And I realized then, oh my gosh, that is truly going to be an unprecedented crisis as far as backsliding from the spiritual path. And we have to be very, very much committed before that happens. It was very much a revelation, that one. Now, after that video in the morning, I had a very, very frightening encounter with a psychopath, and when I could have been killed, actually, and I chose not to be. I was able to get out of that, but I said, holy cow, I must have rocked the boat a little bit. And now I decide, you know what, let us continue on and get focused, ready for the big boost. And that is what I decided to do. But I was kind of shaken for a little while. The end of the world mantra, again, came up with, right now I choose and consent to gravitate towards the path of accepting reality as it is right now. That sort of a mantra that just popped into my mind. And it's a very helpful one. And maybe I can emphasize that at some point again. How to prepare for the big celebration. All right, the big boost, the big celebration, getting ready for it. We need to get ready for it, because as far as I can tell, it's going to happen. What is most important? What is most important? I should try this angle again, because it seemed to be an effective one, very neat and clean and presentable. You are totally deserving, absolutely. Very important message here. The messages are getting more and more clear and direct. I feel that I've been able to progress and get better and better and better at doing this. And it's been quite a workout, quite an experience. And I've gotten more and more comfortable doing it. And I just wing it. Three keys to better destiny. Absolutely. A better news story, a better celebration, and a better locale. These are not also pointers to get ready for what is to come. I'm setting the stage now for what is to come. Almost there, which is true. Very cold this night. Oh boy! So I had to put on bundle up. I was had to put on a warm polar tech hat there for this one. I did this one inside because it was too doggone cold outside. So I just tried this kind of effect inside. And coming up here. Again, very cold, but resonating with reassurance. I mean, I continue to introduce the themes of the big boost one after the other, getting us locked into this. So really, really opening it up and saying, we need to resonate with reassurance, meaning go beyond words. And then this video I actually did this morning, and this was, I think, maybe the best video I've ever done. It just hit on all cylinders. And I was super pleased with it. It got into so much depth that I feel, wow, it actually came after a long meditation in the morning. I got out of bed like about 10:30 in the morning. I must have woken up about 6 or 5 or 6. And I just spent a long time trying to do the very best I could as far as clarification. And I had just some amazing, amazing realizations and breakthroughs. And then I did this video kind of sharing this with everyone. And then this evening I decided to make this video. And there we go. Just did it. It's been quite a ride, unbelievable ride, an incredible process. It's helped me immeasurably. It's been a wonderful experience. The viewers have been absolutely fantastic, better than anything I could have imagined. Really, I just I have been continually amazed of the acceptance that people give this and the respect that people have given, and the way they respond or don't just take it in silently, which is also great to do. It's just been mind-blowing for me. I never thought it would continue on like this. I said, wow, truly amazing, truly amazing, and a great journey. Just, amazing journey. So thank you everybody for going along on this journey, this amazing journey. By any means, that how we have just been going. By any means, we're ragged, but we're right. We're just winging it here, and we're not worrying too much about being too pretty, or fancy or anything. We're just concerned about getting the job done in time because we're running out of time. And I believe we will. I believe I'm on track, on time. I have this very strange, inexplicable quality of being on time. And that's one thing I don't understand. How in the world can I always be on time to the dot? If someone says we need to be somewhere at 4 o'clock and I'm way behind time and there's traffic and everything, somehow I pull in the driveway and then look at the clock and the second hand hits 4 o'clock. How in the world did that happen? And that happens constantly. So somehow I have this tremendous faith and trust that I will be on time because that my whole life has been that way. I'm not going to miss the boat, in other words. Even though I may jump on the boat just in the nick of time, maybe just to be dramatic. I don't know. It's maybe not a greatest quality. Maybe I'm just trying to be too dramatic, like, because the one who jumps on the boat at the last second, everyone's looking. Oh, you made it, right? So maybe I'd really like to be ahead of time. Really, that's much better to do it ahead of time. But I can't seem to shake being right on the dot, right on time. So the way things are unfolding for me, I feel like they're unfolding the way they're supposed to unfold. The progress has been the progress that should take place, and the clarification is the clarification I would expect. I feel I have done a very good job in what I've done, what I've tried to do. I feel I've kept up my end of the bargain, as it were, and I'm looking now to turn the page. We're reaching a page-turning time on this planet. On this hypothetical scenario that's working itself out here, as this planet and these bodies, us being here on this planet, and all of that, it's working out, and everything is exactly the way it should be, the way that it is. I accept it all the way that it is, and it's just been an absolutely amazing situation to be able to actually do these videos. How it all happened is incredible. How I had that little recording area is truly an amazing story. How much I did a ton of work in the yard and And the end result of all that work, I suddenly realized I had this little nook I could, I said, why don't I try recording here? And it just all worked perfectly. And I have a very beautiful spot to do it in. Very peaceful, kind of secluded, open, but also screened off. And I felt just 100% comfortable there, 100%, which is amazing, right? I've never been able to find any other place where I felt 100% comfortable giving talks. And so I just go out there and I just do it. It's that simple. And it's worked out beyond my expectations for sure. So what a ride we've had. And there's our retrospective. And I'm trying to keep it under an hour. Of course, it runs long in keeping with all these videos, which is great practice. Great practice, because it keeps you away from the news, doesn't it? Keeps you away from entertainment, the news, which you want to stay away from right now. You have to be looking at something that's very valuable for you and is very profound right now. Something. So it's either these videos or some other videos or some other audio or something. You need to be paying attention to what's profound, not to what's merely entertaining our new news stuff that's going on in the news. No. Stay away from that. Big time. Stay away from it. You will not regret staying away with it, guaranteed, as I have not regretted spending time on these videos, which has been very all-consuming. It's what I look forward to in each day. Each day I look forward to say, I'm going to do the best I can today, and let us see if I can really share something that has value. And I believe that this has taken place, and it is cutting-edge stuff for sure. It's very high teaching, very cutting-edge. I've been fortunate to have the best teachers, really, the very best teachers, in my opinion, just unbelievable. Who has the blessing of having Jesus as your teacher in A Course in Miracles is simply an incredible help. And then who has the added unbelievable blessing of having Ananda Mahima as your spiritual mentor? That's just off the charts. And then having an experience with Ramana Maharshi blessing what I was doing, telling me to keep doing it. He said, it's going to work, it's going to be very helpful, stick with it. And he said, I know that it's going to be really, really, what you're doing is really good. And who has that happen to him? So I've been super blessed to have all the right kind of mentoring, all the right kind of help. So I'm actually able to say things that that most people would find incredibly audacious to say. And I'm able to say it easily and comfortably because I've worked my entire life on all this stuff, and I have very, very, very clear about it. But it is incredibly audacious. As a matter of fact, a lot of times after I make the videos, I say, what have I done? What have I said? That's crazy. How can you possibly say those things? What are you doing? You know, the police start screaming at me. What are you doing? Oh my gosh. And so I'm like, oh boy, wow, maybe I went too far. Maybe I said too much. And then I have to sleep on it and I get up the next day. And every day somehow I've been able to keep going. But it's not always easy, actually, because I'm pushing the boat, really. Rocking the boat and pushing it and pushing the pace, because I know we're running out of time. So I really pushed the pace and I really said things that are just like, poof, cutting edge stuff that is just strong, adamant type of stuff, because it is necessary to, we're under some time constraints, really severe time constraints, and I felt like you just have to go for it entirely. It's like when you get near the finish line, you've run a long ways, and the finish line, you realize it's getting close. What do? I start going all out for this finish line, because if you don't, you start to, what happens is, you think, oh my gosh, I'm almost there, and I'm so exhausted, I'm so tired, I'm just going to, why don't I just walk the rest of the way? I mean, that's the feeling. I used to run through the mountains, and oh boy, I was just beat when I'd come out of the mountains, and I just wanted, all I wanted to do was just walk. Please let me walk. And then I'd say, no, the finish line is just an eighth of a mile away or whatever, it's close. Why don't you just put on a burst of effort and sprint through that finish line? And I'd say, yeah, why not? Let's do it. And then I'd do it. And it was great. And that's where we're at now. We have this finish line. We really need to get into the big boost and get accept reality as it is and accept the overlay. We need to be very advanced, very far along, and we can do that. And this finish line is coming up, and I saw it, and I said, well, you know what? Let's just sprint all out. Let's just sprint all out to the finish line. And so that's why I taped for so long, and the topic seemed to be relentless and very adamant and very actually advanced kind of teaching. When I'd say nothing's ever happened here, nothing has ever happened here. That's a very advanced teaching, very difficult teaching. I used to struggle with that. It's very difficult to accept, but it is true. It is true. This is all hypothetical. Nothing is really taking place at all here. No one's ever died, and that's tough. But in hearing it, at least you can say, okay, I'm not sure if that's true or not, but I'll consider it. So all of these videos were for your consideration, my consideration, so that when an opportunity knocks, we'll say, you know what, I'm going to consider this opportunity that is knocking also. I'm going to consider it, and I may go with it, actually. And that would be great. It'd be great for all of us. So with that in mind, let me keep this video under 1 hour. And wow, what an amazing trip, huh? What an amazing trip. Shall I just go blasting through these videos really fast? Let me see if I can do that. What an amazing trip. What a long, strange trip it's been, but a beautiful one for sure. And I mean, wow. Just looking at this, it just touches me. Just saying, really went for it. And all different styles. Some technical problems. I'm son of them. And thank you for everybody for bearing with me as I struggled to get this all out to you. It didn't always go smoothly, but you know what? Most of the time it did. And I believe the essential message was presented, has been presented, and a general overall context has been brought to light that at least people are hopefully considering. So I'll continue to. We're just going through all these videos here. And one last retrospective here. And I will keep going. I don't know what's going to happen with me or with anything. I don't know what is going to happen exactly. So I just say, okay, it's okay. I accept that. I don't know what's going to happen. And I just accept it. But I will certainly try to keep myself safe and sane and very functional and very effective and very helpful. And I have a lot of capabilities, actually, to do something, to share something, to share some help. And I will try, of course, to max out those abilities. But again, if the grace of God is guiding in a certain way, that's what's going to happen. It may not always be what you think is going to happen or what you want to have happen. I hope I don't get interrupted here. Sometimes I get interrupted, but what can I do? That's the nature of the world, isn't it? Sometimes when you're contemplating, you get interrupted, don't you? And so this is cinema verite, really, what I've done here. Just so you realize, hey, yeah, you have to do it right in the midst of your life. You can't wait to be in some Tibetan cave. You cannot wait for that. You've got to do it right now in the midst of all the complexities and hustle bustle of your life. And so no excuses. No excuses at all. You can't make excuses. So when I get interrupted, I just try to do the best I can. And thank you for putting up with that. Sometimes I have to just go to black here. And hopefully I can get through this. I don't know. Look at all this stuff. 52 or 3 videos. My gosh, that's a lot of videos. 133 hours, and maybe we've just begun. Who knows? I just feel like the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come. I really feel that way. That all this effort to prepare has got to be for some really great reason. You know, I feel that way. I can't promise it, but I feel that way. That it's leading to something that is going to be even more profound than what we have so far. And this has been very profound stuff, actually. Very profound stuff. I'm very proud to have been able to present this. It's been a great blessing. And I feel that the content has been quite profound, and that's very helpful for everyone, actually. Not easy for any of us, I know. It's not easy. Spiritual facts are quite difficult to get, really. Quite difficult. All right, there you go. We did it. Thank you all very, very much. And that's it for this video.